Friday. We're going to just go ahead and apply ourselves to receive the word of the Lord. It won't be before you very long. Praise God. As long as the Lord says talk, that's as long as I'm going to talk. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Let's pray for a moment. Father, we bless your name. Hallelujah. We give you all the praise and all the glory. Let's do you. Hallelujah. Without you, what would we be? What can we do without you? We thank you, Father, for being the supplier of our strength. We thank you, Father, for our peace. We thank you for the love that you've given. Open up our hearts and our minds today that we might hear. Hallelujah. And hear and believe. Hallelujah. My believing will show glory and honor to your name. Give you all the praise and glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. It's having an honor to be here. Pastor and Sister Hill spoke again this morning. They're up in the St. Louis area. And so they're doing good, resting. She'll be back sometime after Tuesday, I believe. And told them that she'll let me know. I might get a ticket and go up there with them. And that's how they call me out to get there. I can take a hint. We thank God for them, and we'll just carry on because we love the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
Call according to His purpose. Glory to God. And I think I saw, Evangelist Scott. God bless you. He just came to the house. God bless him. And we want to talk as kind of continue what we were speaking on Wednesday night. With a focus on prayer and responsibility, to assume responsibility for prayer and realizing all of the benefits that prayer does for us. We thank God for those who did mention. Thanks to Sister Irene was here. What are you here with tonight? Brother Travis and Terrence and his wife was here. And I just can't think of others right now, but I just can remember what was said from those that was here. And we saw and determined that we are responsible one to another. And when you come in on Sunday mornings, I come in and I ride on Brother Travis's prayer every Sunday morning between 9 and 9:30. He'd be in here walking around, going on, praise God. So my first 5 or 10 minutes, I'm getting my strength from him. The Bible says we go from strength to strength, faith to faith, every one of us appearing before the Lord. So when I come into the sanctuary, the atmosphere is already created. Good environment, I can go off on someone else's strength. Now, when I come into the sanctuary and I don't see anybody, I don't see Sister Irene for 2 or 3 or 4 months, praise God, my strength is not as high as it could be because she's not here in presence. Her voice, whatever she does, is not here, praise God. So we are responsible. If you look around and you don't see another believer, another saint, you can almost take responsibility for, I got to go find that person. Mm-hmm. Give them a call. Give them a shout. Rattle their cage. Find out what's going on with them. We need you in the sanctuary. Praise God. It's good to say I'm with you in spirit, but we need you in what? Presence. Hallelujah. Amen. So we need one another. Praise God. We studied in Sunday school this morning that there's a way to kill your brother without shooting him with a gun in the head. You can mess up your brother or your sister by your behavior, your acts, what you do, and it can cause them to wane. But if they see you in prayer, in Bible study, going forth in the strength of the Lord, they get strengthened. We go from strength to strength. Praise God. Every one of us. Borrowing off of the other one. Praise God. If you don't think you don't need your brother and sister, this show up in here by yourself one day, on Sunday morning. Let's see how loud you shout in. Yeah. Glory to God. So only 2 or 3 of us in here, see how you feel like you've had church after an hour and a half. No, we need everybody in the sanctuary. So, hallelujah. All right, this morning, let's talk and let's look into the word regarding wanting to be blessed. How many want to be blessed? Amen. How many tired, or tired, broke, sick, ugly, stupid? Hallelujah. Oh, we don't, I'm going to have to go across the street to tell you. I think they open it there. We won't recognize, or we won't say, but we know we want to break through to the blessed life. Amen. I think the scripture Sister Denise talked about Wednesday night is Mark 11:23-24. Whatsoever things you desire when you pray. And the key word there is desire. You got to have a desire to want to be blessed. Yeah, and I think that's ingrained in us. It comes with us at birth. We want to be blessed. We want the God kind of life. But the devil will pervert and twist and show you things that are not of God. You think that's the real deal. But that is not the real deal. God wants you blessed and happy. The blessings of God make you rich and add, you know what? No sorrow with it. Praise God. So God wants you blessed. And you have that ingrained within you. A few weeks ago, I mentioned the biblical character Jabez. How many remember that a few weeks back? I asked you to look it up and look at that scripture, 1 Chronicles 4:9. Let me get there right quick. I think I'm there. Yeah, 1 Chronicles 4:9. And Jabez was more honorable than his brother. That's what it says in 1 Chronicles 4:9. Jabez was more honorable than his brethren. His mother called his name Jabez, saying, because I bear him with sorrow. In other words, he had a terrible life. He was born in unfavorable situations. And he realized it, his mother realized it, that life has dealt us a bad hand. But he was an honorable man before God. More honorable than his brethren. And verse 10 says, and Jabez, knowing his situation, and Jabez called on the God of Israel, saying, oh, that thou wouldest bless me indeed, and enlarge my coast, and that thy hand might be with me, and that thou wouldest keep me from evil, that it may not grieve me. And God granted him which he requested. So Jabez says, God, you got to do it. You got to make the difference. And all I want you to do is indeed bless me. And keep evil away from me. Keep sickness, keep poverty, keep heartache, depression, all of these things of the devil, keep it away from me. How many would say that prayer today? Courageous enough to say that prayer today. Amen. God, without you, I got heartbreak, I got misery, I have poverty, I have illnesses, I have sickness, I have all of things contrary to life. God, without you. So God, I want you to bless me. Amen. Praise God. So let's look into the New Testament, if we will, for a minute. 1 Peter 2, verse 9. We've heard it before several times. Some of us are familiar with it, can even quote it. When I'm turning there, 1 Peter 2:9, it says, But you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people, that you should show forth the praises of him who have called you out of darkness into his marvelous light, which in time past were not a people, but are now the people of God, which had not obtained mercy, but now have obtained mercy. So here is what the Apostle Peter is getting to us. And I just want to say that you are appointed. You and I are appointed. The word chosen, just substitute appointed. You are an appointed generation. You are a royal priesthood. And that's what I want to major on today, is that you and I we have been appointed. The Bible says that you did not choose Jesus, but he chose you. And he has ordained you. Now, I don't care where you come from. If you come from a household that's upside down, crooked and crazy, or you come from a blessed environment, things goes well there, and you experience that good stuff all your life. But once you have been redeemed, and chosen for eternal life. The Bible clearly tells you that you are appointed to this. This was your destiny. Hallelujah. There's no way you was going to walk this earth without having interference from God saying that your destiny is salvation. Your destiny is to be a priest on the earth. Your destiny is to be a special chosen vessel. You can let your background from all the way forward until today override all of that if you want to. But I'm here to tell you today, you should from this day forward see yourself as chosen, picked out, and separated on this earth. Peculiar, royal. You should be wearing purple, somebody. Hallelujah. Some of us got it going on. Hallelujah. You should have an attitude that I am chosen of God, and I have a mission to accomplish, and I will experience the goodness of the Lord on this earth. Hallelujah. So Jabez realized that my address is not where I want it to be, but I know who I can call on to get it to change. And he says that if you, see, the Almighty, the Everlasting, the Father of Glory, the Creator of heaven and earth, if you, he didn't have the reality of Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. All he had was the reality that there is an invisible God who is the Creator of all things, and he makes the difference. And I have to rely on him. So, as we've been talking about prayer, what we're going to find out is that when we don't avail ourselves, when we don't make it a practice, a fabric of our existence, that we are neglecting the most powerful force that can make a difference in your life. And Wednesday I said, how many, you know, we talked about what has prayer done for you? How many experienced prayer when you was up against a wall in life and you knew you was not going to come out good? Matter of fact, all the experts says that's it for you. And you know that you called on God and a difference was made. Regardless of your church, your family, people, you knew that you called on God, and that was where the difference was made. So we got so many things, so many sounds in the world today that we can, we can depend on a lot today. Even the internet, the iPhone, the smartphone, iPod. Okay, so many places we can go that we can seek answers. But still, from the rising of the sun to it goes down on the same day, there is only one that can give you the real deal that you need. And that is to get you to break through all of the things that's got you surrounded negatively. There is a breakthrough for you. And you have to desire to come out of that. Hallelujah. Glory to God. How do you not be sick